ball flip to hit it. Oh, he's gone for the goal! That's scored!
Maybe if Paul Flynn was an ultra-dedicated guy who, you know, looked after himself 24 hours a day, maybe that would have gotten him into a mental state that he wouldn't have been able to perform the acts that he performed.
The goal scorer in the first half. Getting by Brian Geary. Nice, clever play. That's a lovely point.
I'd say if I took it so serious, considering all the disappointments and mistakes I made, I probably would have given up a lot earlier.
On Clistock de Vega, a vet in San Oi cart, Egonom cart. Con score oil, Eg Aumana Hawthor.
Drop the ball.
Hossa Paul Flynn a gimmert le port laur ige dasoch ag level na minúr agus froshead cluffy canish na héirin an idag leich a dó. Fiún tamsin, fi uolach an tlaanay hóra ar a gwaili óga.
It was the first time a Waterford minor team had been there since 48. It wasn't really any hype that got to us. It was the Galway centre-back on the day, Conor O'Donovan, who absolutely cleaned us.
On Vrinshin Nokado, right, you know, could have got Fefehene come out. Bullier could have talent for Lehig Portlariga.
Agus throw for in the 5 lane of his 5th for Tlariga, Cluffy Canish the Hayden in Nayu Valley. Honey Polish Dach Marona the Hedla at Rub, a Hussishes and Yamurst.
The selectors probably thought more about it than I did. Like, I mean, I remember being told, like, oh, this is, you know, we're taking a big chance, but, you know, I kind of thought, well, you're either going to put me in or you're not.
Paul Flynn really gets it back to Noli Galton. Paul gets it on the second attempt. He's 45 metres out. He's going on a run. The ball is on his stick. Paul Flynn is released by two off him and he takes a shot on the run. It's over the bar from the Lansdowne belly gunner. Paul Flynn comes across. Great take by the belly gunner. 45 metres out. Flynn takes his shot. He's done it all. Over the bar. The lead for Waterford. Paul Flynn has done it.
Tíist go ochmí bhí sé ar idirn haintear a chundé.
Caid tú bheith speisialta chun dul roi gan na minúirí díra go staach go dtí na síntrí.
After the minor year and 21 years, it was kind of like, when is this going to happen?
An céad cluiche riamh i gcimirt ó Fort Lauderdale fuair sé trí cúil agus gá cúilín as a 3-3 diag.
In 1980, beár le muintir na néise dearmad a dhéanamh ar a Cluaigh Chéanna.
From a hurling point of view, having won an under-21 All-Ireland the year before and to lose the first round of the Munster Championship, it was disastrous.
Leanach na droch horrig o Fort Lauderdale, agus leanach wolach na fregrachta ar gwaili óga Paul Flynn.
Is Queen Lumsa clihi dvina tosi ele i gligin siar, agus vi si di gligin to Paul Flynn na scór na galera oil. Agus sin brú anna vúr a vi ar lad óg, ir a siof nidig fe no fe hin.
An tuairim bhionig an sonach go háil ná lo más fead leat Paul Flynn a bhar cháil as an imirt mar a defar, you know, bhí leat i gynna Port Lárigi.
Going to Cork and Turles year after year, first round of the Munster Championship, you know, not getting beaten, but getting well beaten, you know, it was starting to kind of turn things a little sour.
A chonig blank dóch is a dorachadas na a capú Gerald McCarthy mar vainistúid ag deirin na dhibnaicha sé.
If you didn't train, you wouldn't be picked. It didn't matter what club you were from or who you were, and you had to train hard. I suppose it was hard to kind of bluff your way past the 5-time All-Ireland winner.
Chuisit chafadu le Cluaigh Canish na Strahan eich ahocht. An chéad Cluaigh Canish na Oshun Takab le Chuaigh Vlian agus Tríocha.
The man over the ball is Paul Flynn.
It was a real hot day, I remember, anyway, in Turles. Possibly a game we could have won.
Doing well. However, it's his direct opponent, Ken McGrath, that has possession, and that's all of the ball.
We didn't really put him under enough pressure to kind of threaten him.
Alan Brown kicking it up, and there's a goal for Cork. Cork have just won their 14th league title.
Great joy in hurling circles at the return to the big stage at Waterford.
Ní stiúrnín bhí an chéanna, bhí tibradárin le obi glufi leith cheannis na mún. Conde nach rob bwiltig na deisio sa gruif o 1983.
To Paul Flynn, they're making room for Paul Flynn. He's doing ever so well, Paul Flynn, this afternoon. Liam Sheedy there to help Tipperary too. But Waterford come attacking. Good ball into Flynn. He's delivering on all that thrilling potential that was in this gifted young man as a minor and as an under-21.
It was one of like, we're on the road more so than we've arrived. And obviously the road had many twists and turns ahead.
Agus na tibrodí cluite, bhí áit baintamach ag a beglufiig ceannais na mún don gédhúir ó 1989, in aghaidh Éireann an bráite chun chláir.
Hall White's waiting across the man in the red helmet. It's going to be a free in for Waterford.
Honey pointy kin on the glyph, agus hit you fragrocht, marbog nachlish, air fall.
I used to concentrate on the lift a lot. I used to practice. I'd actually lift the ball, say, 20 times without striking it. I knew if I lifted it properly and I had it where I wanted, that I could hit it, say, sweet enough or get good enough contact on it. Lifted it properly and struck it well.
Vin puck seer bought you. Ach ver Connelle, nice tavocht if you. Couple of seconds in the ishin.
Here's Brian Flannery trying to get that ball away. Tony Brown, what a high challenge by PJ O'Connell. Right to the face as we head into injury time with the sides level.
Willie, of course, said this is the last puck in the game, which I said, oh, great. and I was just talking there about lifting the ball so perfectly, and on that occasion, I actually didn't.
A strong breeze backing him. What chance has he of getting it? It's high. Seems to be going to the right, and it's gone wide.
I've been told since, oh, it was a great free, but the wind came in over the stand and took it away. But no, that wasn't the case. It was a big tail on it.
There's still a few seconds, Willie Barrett decides. Not anymore. It's all over. And the Munster hurling final has finished level.
Coral Martian. Ach an rodeis cáil teag na déise ar fís a stair is scríomh. Chaisiad ar eich eil ar ísht an dúnach dar gíon agus bhí atmosfér hára bheith difriúl an a tamsha.
Once again, Willie Barrett is the man in the middle for a mighty Munster final replay
compensation. Pórlaig a gónaí is a moana hiad, right? Ní fiadlo bheith talent a stach in tridana fysicúla mar cáilig siad na tridana son.
It was when Brian Lone and Micheál White got sent off. That's when you kind of realised, oh, you know, could be anybody here.
Bolu Portlaoí go go heis cos an éhamhairt. Ach tíos go hachtin, Bolu gaile mauta caru cianais na héirin agus iad sa glufi le cianais dun gédhwyr o 1963. In aí bháistirí na hamana, cil chunye.
If you were offered I learned semi-final against Kilkenny and they only scored 111. Like, you take it.
Good evening, Hocha. Ach vech ar Fort Laurige, it allied hean a heanie go aimshu.
About 5-10 minutes left in that game, Paul came through with a ball. Typical Paul came onto a lovely break, sidestepped a man, and they fly with a shot, and it only went inches wide.
Shot. Oh, just got outside, so close.
It wasn't a clear-cut chance, as in a certain goal, but it was definitely one that should have been put on target anyway.
Kegra and Vlienig Portlaoí in the hocht, a Darren Lee near a Ian Horan Grew Jacob. Wide Ray, John McCarthy, your Fetchery, Blianella, Blianta Gamwa, Achvi Flynn Forbes to Hutchkill and Agoni, Samaila Lena Club, Bailevikunid.
Ray Whitty, our club goalie, we were up early one night for training and Ray poked the ball back to me and Wimbledon was on at the time. And whatever way it bounced in front of me, nearly went straight over my head and I saw, like, he hit it with a bit of topspin. So I hit it back in with him, at him with a bit of topspin and it ducked under his hurley. So I kept at it for a few minutes and I said, there might be something in this.
Shove out the heart. As you go, Moody Kundera, catch a cool the arms. As you put your job, put it in Trasnon, Harry Trasnon.
I do remember one of the club selectors at the time said, he said, someday one of them will come off.
I did in the play on the shin of V. Paul looks a club, Bailevic Gunnard, a glyphic canish the moon, and I hurry her horka on Harigov.
Paul Foley getting out the Cummins. Ashaya Park in Eastern Gear, and it's a Stefan Lane. Look at Paul Flynn.
It was absolutely fantastic to be part of a winning team at long last.
My shin, Bogan Untuk, our fad, Augusta Hookshare, on the Fane Vinny, Nihawan, the Winter Valley Gunner, Ach, Winter Port Larga Frischen.
Agus curulish an fein vunin sin na de capo Justin McCarthy mar vanished at Fort Laudige.
He was renowned, you know, as a hurling man. We had a meeting in Dungarvan with the panel, and he laid down that, you know, things were going to be hurling orientated, and I think that grand. No more laps.
Agus ní raibh do gur ar an éis a glufi canais na mún, an dár na huaid an imocht chéir a bliana. Go gairid rúb le hama, bhí jab eil a le díana ag Paul Flynn.
An táftag agus an táma hánise, díruach rúb le hama, con Munina Hort to Winter Port Lorica.
That is a huge free. All the way down towards Sherry Prendergast, and here's a chance, and that's a goal by Tony Brown. And they're flying again. Dave Bennett. They're also confident. Tipper is finishing. Waterford are the Munster hurling champions. First time since 1963.
You could see the town terrace in Cork was full of water for people. Grown men crying, kids, young kids, you know, they were lucky enough to... I never saw a Waterford team winning a Munster title. Seldom enough did I see a Waterford team win a match in Turles. So they'd something to maybe emulate or play in their back garden as, you know, they could go home and be Waterford. They didn't have to be Cork or Kilkenny or Tipperary. And I think that was probably the biggest thing out of it, that the future hurlers of Waterford had something to aim for.
Farrier, craw crui vina on ar ishto na I chlaari glwyfi leach anis na heilin.
Nier yn report ar ag amaan laasin, yna agus inchi cwpla bo tuun.
At a very judicious time. Problems. Markham! Back of the net. In towards Flynn, they need a goal. And it's a great block.
The game fizzled out from a Waterford point of view to a very disappointing defeat.
Vidr Dimo Chalashin, ach vi bon na mounaige, agus tille fos le hiocht. Gha vilig sa tri, Paul Flynn agus Port Laudige ar eis a glwfi canis na moun, yn ai chorca, brunu puc sir ar hwb, agus chonig Paul I eis.
Jersey was being pulled, he's fired up, but it gives water for the chance.
Ni ecwg mwyn an dyn ye. You know, Conic Flynn agus the vi an bushin ag Flynn agon.
Just walking away, and he was maybe 8 yards out from the goal. There was no one near him. And I thought he was looking, and I hit it, and he wasn't. And I shouted, Mull! And thank God he turned around. And in fairness, he was nearly gone past me, caught it.
He's going to take it, goes short. To Milan! Goal!
It worked, yeah. Paul Flynn was brave enough to do it. Give it to
no, it wasn't pre-planned, or if that went past his ear, which it could have just as easy. We wouldn't be talking about it for a different reason.
It would have influenced our way of defending frees for a good many years afterwards, that incident that with Flynn that day, if you like. He taught us a very good lesson.
Ach dear Vlora, call na deisha, ach vina fórni keana lina chéle rishti vlian dar dian. Vi drachus ag Port Laudige, agus deir a coursi nis mass of os, le dibert John Milan.
It's red.
When Milan was sent off that day, I think Flynn really threw off the shackles and, you know, took on the responsibility that, if you like, had been bestowed upon him.
Flynn striking, and that's a nice return! Aware that he was about to be challenged, that looks okay. Paul Flynn strikes it brilliantly.
I remember Dan catching the ball, and it was a dubious enough free, I think.
When Flynn was lining up, we would have known that there was danger. He was still probably, you would have thought, two farrows.
Referee telling Paul Flynn to take it back.
I looked at the scoreboard. I do remember they were 2 points down.
Near a visigun, cut a harlock, up to Virodegan or Shul.
The one thing I didn't want was that we didn't get a score for it.
Flynn goes for a goal!
Caffan credum to what Paul Flynn got a bit shin and rudder being agony.
There was very few players, if any, would have taken that on in that situation.
Cork were a
expecting him to just lob it over.
Ik fechan sheer ar an ish na blienta an is denny. Is all am sigur of ishin un cool of arach an ik mishar reed.
There's where it finished. Top right hand corner of the net as we look at it.
She had the cut of her own police, the glove for Yash Anish, because Nia took a toast for the Nadesha and Venice Massa.
Honey Portar Garnash, I could speak Paul Flynn around some notion. For which a 3 deal to Coolini as a hook deal.
Floating around the field and knocking off some great scores, especially trademark points from Paul, and he was a real handful that day.
Paul Flynn, his leadership and ability now so crucial. He's kept over the bar. He really is the only one that has threatened. Referee blows his whistle, and Gazzini are in the All-Ireland final. Waterford are devastated. None more so than Paul Flynn. Eddie Brennan consoles with him.
Rá vilgus a seacht a bhí an sa le roisiant eilig na déis ar chorann. Cluffy Cánish na sraha, ach bhí Paul ar mínse.
Spadr o bwadr, sain a siúnta, o chreir mŵr gwyt i gwyna tamad a blinta. Frenra gastan is tos hosio chan cain.
I suppose it's a special day for Waterford to pick up a National League title. They were certainly up for that game. They really drove into Kilkenny that day and all the Waterford lads were on top of their game.
Bishir Asher of Wadil Namshir Craven the Moon, August Pona in to Haka by Horka, August Erlinda.
As we watch this once again come in from a huge distance from Paul Flynn, Waterford are the Munster hurling champions for 2007.
Fair, Kevin Tarquin, Ridge Cool Doris, Cliffy, Carol Canish, and Hayden. Korka, Cliffy, or a clear Hans Bodjaklish.
Here's on the ground, inside, there's a chance here for Waterford. It has to go inside. He's inside the cover, he's going to go. What down? There's a redemption, and again, blocked again on the goal line. Donald Cusick is there.
I don't think you see any other team, definitely that I played against, that in an All Ireland quarter final, your straight through goals are a point down, and you still go for the goal. And I think that was one of the great qualities of that Waterford team.
Shantahi Cusick, you know, on a clistic the vintage, Lee Sharon's litter. The Gano, Shane Rutherhorlu, a chasach on Red Hor and the Slitter Stock. Magni Horlish, a Kushish Stock, a Storche, Poxy or Town.
Here it is, over the bar, side
travel. Shacht Lawn Yeshin, Vina Hammerstone.
It was a weird championship because we played Limerick and Cork in Munster, played Cork in the quarter-final twice, and here we are again playing Limerick.
It has a Munster final feeling about it.
Na clihí sin ag an Corkig, you know, da bhí anabhrú. Ar na himróri go léir, ar an luclanúna go léir, ar an fúrm banis díochta, you know, agus bhí ambush cart, bhí sé olaf ag Limerick.
Disappointing afternoon for John Mullan. Didn't quite happen for him. This is an absolute crisis now for Waterford, I feel. John Mullan gone, Paul Flynn gone.
My chances of affecting the game are gone. I knew that. But to take John off, like when he was fully fit, was probably a bad idea.
Tossa own, I guess, is coming up to Keiko Hulk as a Tashi de Gimmert, and he went to Reard and Barkid, in Horamshire, right? Mar, Chucky Glee Road. I guess my hugging chance, your cheating chance.
It's all over! Limerick have beaten the Munster champions, Waterford! They have avenged their defeat at the hands of the Dead
Shot. I went straight in and into the toilets and closed the door. And I'd say I spent 15, 20 minutes in staring at the door. here was another chance, a real chance of winning the All-Ireland. Gone. We were probably the second best team in Ireland at the start of 08. And there was no other stage in my career I could have said that, and to walk away from it would have been a mistake.
Near later to the Gomus and I Claude, you'd boil to good dinner, because I've just initial the him you're in my stood.
It's talk a gorev, an omatahi a chor a chelia, you know, an on gochene.
There was a vote taken, yeah, and the majority of the squad voted for a change. The county board went away and appointed the new manager without any consultation with the players.
Capo Davy Fitzgerald Marvani stood, agus fina stúr vodur ar Eintrum, Iwani, agus Loch Garman, laat you aint imach a glwyf vil eich anis na heidan yn ei hebrodorin. Ach ni'r hos a Paul ein glwyfu, e ffocu i'r imeinche ag ymlaen I stúr nhw.
Waterford are serious championship contenders.
One-handed forward by Dan Shannon. Oh, it's on the goal line, and it's in the back of the net! And the whistle has gone, and Waterford have qualified for the All-Ireland Hurling Final.
To get to the final was huge, but knowing that you weren't going to be picked, no matter what happened, it was difficult.
The Waterford Hurling team playing at Croke Park in the All-Ireland Final for the first time since 1963.
The whole hurling aspect of the All-Ireland Final was gone. We were climbing, canoeing, jumping in off the pier in Carlingford. Meanwhile, Kilkenny were playing 6 50-minute matches, hard hurling against each other.
A little bit of aggro breaking out here between Seamus Prendergast and Tommy Welch.
I think we lost a bit of respect. There's no question that the first 5 minutes of that All-Ireland, or even a minute before it, wasn't one of our finest achievements.
Looking back, they'll probably say they probably made a few mistakes and they got probably a bit too pent up and targeted a couple of our players and a couple of areas on our team. It kind of seemed to backfire on them, you know, but to be honest, I think Kenny just hit one of them days that day, and there was Waterford or whoever we were going to be playing, we're going to have no answer.
There's another opportunity for Fogarty this time. First time stop, second time buried, two in a row for Eddie Brennan, and this final looks to be consigned to the ashes. There was never any doubt. The final whistle, they beat Waterford by 23 points.
Would we have been better off not to have got there? A match that lads had given their life for, sacrificed a lot for, and it was the worst experience, I'd say, you could have.
Vi críoch roivéloch le tréf se einta chomona, Paul Flynn, in Yanzi for Tlárige.
Like, to me, it was always a simple game, and I think the simpler it's played, the better it is.
While the forwards we played against, there would definitely be a place for Flynn.
No cahocht, but he got Felix a hocht. Vishishimar, Creelar, Iroti, Fortalig, and the Blintishin.
Certainly, you know, we would have taken him in open arms if he was the other side of the bridge.
You know, four, Sean Kelly, the cyclist, had spoken to us earlier in that year, and he said, there'll be some day somewhere when everything will be worth it.
Well, toshe naam kurte hurte.